I wanted to play with an idea today, guys. So I've put my music quite low and wanted to suggest, obviously, once we start class, I get everyone to turn their microphones off. So I encourage you to pop your own playlist on so that you're jamming to the kind of tunes that you like to jam to, or yoga to, like however you want to put it. But that's only if you want to. I thought it'd be a fun thing to do because when I'm doing my yoga, so I usually come into my little space and start doing yoga before I come and teach you guys. I like to warm up a bit so I'm not quite so icy cold. And I jam to my own tunes and I'm like, oh yeah, I'm feeling the vibes and I get my movement on and I'm like, oh, man, I'm feeling inspired. So it's sometimes fun to just do your own thing. So yeah, that's my thought. You can do it if you want to or not. Your business. So it's 9 o'clock, so we get to start. Let's come into our easy seat and get your hips tucked under, belly lifted. The kind of breathing I'm wanting to do is, oh guys, everything for me is fun. It's fun breathing. So we're going to start off sort of really slouched, and we're going to start off with an empty breath. So you're going to get to this point where you're exhaled. Then as we breathe in, we're going to start lifting that air up, 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 and we're lengthening the spine, lengthening the spine, lengthening the spine as we inhale, slow and steady, obviously, through the nose. And then as we exhale through our mouth, again, slow and steady, it's like we're deflating. And then we'll inhale. Exhale. You can use your hands with me if you like. I like the feeling. It makes me feel like I'm pulling things up and then magically deflating like a cool little balloon. And you just go at your own pace. You're trying to breathe in as deep as you can. I go to a point where I almost feel like on that inhalation, I'm almost reaching that space where I suspend my breath, but actually I'm still taking a little bit of extra air in. And then I can't pull anything else in. That's when I start slowly. Down again. And at that end point, you're again almost getting to that point of suspension. You push a little bit harder just to make sure you're exhaled, and then you start the inflation all over again. Okay, so let's go. So we're starting off exhaled in through the nose. Out through the mouth and deflate. Inhale. Exhale. Keep going at your own pace. one last round. And allow your breathing to just return to its normal, natural movement in and out. I don't know whether you guys are actually aware of why we do pranayama and the purpose behind it and the sort of the ideas behind it. So I'm just going to share with you as you get your breathing back into a normal space. So prana is thought of as this life force energy which runs through our bodies, and it's not actually the air we breathe, and yet it is part of the air we breathe. And so when you bring in that breath work and that paying attention to the movement of your prana, like I said, it's an energy, it's not necessarily air, but it's interrelated with your air, because you bring in your prana through your nose. And then the energy actually shifts. So you've got, I think it's five vayus, which are energy systems related to the prana that are working in your system, that are also interrelated to your chakras. And again, the whole functioning of your entire body. You've got the, I think it's the prana vayu in the chest, which brings in the oxygen and starts this whole oxygenation of your blood and your movement. I can't remember all the names of the vayus right now, but they've got there's a vayu that deals specifically with your digestive system. So you bring in this oxygenation into your body, which helps your body do its elimination, getting rid of the toxins and etc. etc. You've got the vayu that works purely with the circulation throughout the body. So although you're bringing your air into this vayu area, there's a vayu that is specifically for getting your oxygenation through to the rest of your body to create healthy functioning. So when we're working on our pranayama, we're actually helping our entire body function at a more optimal level. You know, nowadays, I don't know whether any of you have paid attention to how you breathe during the day, but it's almost our natural breathing now, even though it's actually quite unnatural, to breathe very shallowly. It's also why even when you're slouching, our rib cage can't expand as much. So we breathe like just a little bit, just getting, you know, the air into just barely function. When we sit up straighter and we start letting our breath increase and sort of deep breathing, we want to practice so that maybe we can actually get to a point where we're deep breathing throughout the entire day. And the thinking behind that is essentially you would create more health in your body purely from breathing properly throughout the entire day. So that's something to dwell on, BTW. Okay, so today we're going to start off sort of just warming up our hips a bit before we get into the more fun movement. So you can turn onto the side of your mat. If you've got a lot more space and you're comfy, then you can stay whichever way you're on your mat. I'm going to stay facing you guys so you can see me. So we're starting with our legs open, and we're just going to drop one knee towards the floor, and we're sort of getting into this hip, almost hip flexor area, going into these little joints just over here. So you should feel it going into almost the groin area, going into the hip capsule as you sit here. I'm leaning a bit back so that my hands can be on the floor, because I noticed if you do this without any purchase, you end up wiggling your bum all the way off the mat and off down the road somewhere. Remember to keep the tummy lifted and the hips tucked under, so we're not arching in this position, but tucking. And then fold over to the other side. It's really, it goes into the hip capsule, which for me personally is like a meanie, but it's a good stretch to actually work on. Over to the first side. Over again. And we go over again. Back onto the first side. to the last side. This is the last one. Back together. We're going to drop our knees in together. We're trying to make sure that the knees and the ankles are in alignment. So if you find your, like I am, my ankles are a little bit further forward, I'm just crawling my feet back to try and get them in line with my knees, and then I start leaning them in. It again goes into this hip capsule space, but you should be feeling it in a different area. Keep sucking your belly back and tucking your hips under. If you feel like you're not feeling this much at all, you can actually start crawling your feet away from you and bringing your knees back together, and it starts going into a deeper and deeper and deeper stretch. Gently walk the feet back together. Now I'm going to turn sideways on my mat. Oh, and our legs are straight out in front of us. Oh, these exercises that we're about to do can be a little bit challenging, but they're really good for our legs, especially if you find that your legs tend to be a little bit weak, which women in general, we tend not to use our legs as much as we ought to. So we're going to have our hands behind us initially. Push down in the hands so that you don't slouch in your shoulders. The shoulders are pushing down away from the ears. Let's flex our feet, and we'll start with the left leg. Make sure you're tucking your hips under, sucking your belly back, and you're even squeezing your bum a bit to help support you as you lift this leg up and put it back down. Lift it up and put it back down. Lift it up and put it back down. And we're going over to the right leg. I'm only doing three of each because as we progress, it can get a bit more challenging, more challenging, more challenging. But later on, if you practice this again at home, you can choose how many times you continue. So right leg, lift up. Keep belly lifted, tucking hips under and down. Lift up. And down. Lift up. And down. Now we're going to open our leg, our left leg, out. I'm going to call it a 45 degree angle. It's outwards. It's not straight in front of you. Keep these hips tucked under. Squeeze the bum to help you support this leg. Then lift it. Then we Sierra. So from your hip, you twist, twist on your way down, twist, and down we go. So there are about three twists. Up we come. Twist, 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 and you're down. Last one, lift up, twist, 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 down. Close your leg, open the other leg up to 45 degrees. I'm just shimmying slightly so that I'm not on the wall. Tuck, squeeze the bum muscles, lift the leg. Twist, 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 down. Lift the leg, twist, 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 down. Last one, lift the leg, twist, 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 down. Did a good job. Now we're going to have both legs open, readjust because we're not leaning back anymore. So these are the ones that can get a little bit more challenging. And again, you might go into your hip flex if you're not keeping your hips tucked under and your belly lifted. So pay attention to the belly area and the hip area. Don't allow yourself to try and go into an arch and lift your legs up. You're going to get into the wrong places and it's going to get sore. So I'm starting with my left leg. I'm placing my tippy fingers on the floor because again, it's not that I want to push down with my hands, but I do want my hands to help me a little bit as I tuck my hips under, lift the belly. I'm sucking that belly backwards, activating this leg, starting to activate the bum muscle, and you just lift up and down, up and down, up and down. So get into like a little deep, it's not quite inner thigh, but it's up here where we don't actually feel it all the time. So over to the other side. Make sure we're tucking under, we're lifting in the belly, we're squeezing our bum, lift that leg up and down. Up and down. Up and down. Whew, okay, shake out, wiggle the legs. Now we're gonna add in Sierra. Okay, so back to the left leg. Tuck, squeeze the bum, lift the leg. Twist, 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 drop down. First, the other leg, right leg, lift it up, twist, 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 down. Whew. First leg, up, twist, 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 down. Last one, lift the right leg, twist, 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 down. There we go. So you can feel how it's getting into interesting areas in the upper thighs. Okay, cool. So from here, open your legs. You can see my bum's actually quite far away from my feet because we're crawling over into our yogi squat. So if you feel more comfortable with your legs further away and crawling up, or if you like your feet really close to you as you come up, it's entirely your choice. We're trying to keep our feet parallel, so we don't want them opened up to the side at a 45 degree. We want to keep them straight. Try and get your chest through. If you can, you put your hands together and you push your arms against your knees. You're sucking your belly back, tucking your hips under, and just feeling like a lower back opening, a little bit of a stretch into the hips. Instead of reminding you to breathe all the time, I'm just going to start breathing a little bit louder to ignite your memory as well. So remember, we just allow the breath to come in and out of the body. Try not to forget about your breathing. Try not to go shallow. Try not to hold your breath, especially when you're in a sore spot. Okay, up we come to standing. We're going to come to the front of our mat. You remember how we root down with the feet? So we're really, imagine you're growing roots down into the earth to keep you really nice and firm and stable. Tuck the hips under, make the knees turn out slightly. I'm not going to take my hands to the sky today because I'm not doing a sun salutation exactly. We're just going over into a forward fold to get to where I want us to go. So drop forward, hang in your forward fold for a few moments. It's cold this morning, so try not to make yourself go too deep, and if your knees are slightly bent to just help you out, it's fine. We're not trying to whip it right now, she says before she makes you whip it. Place your hands on the floor, and we're going to take our right leg back. Leaning forward with our right hip, so we're thinking about this hip flexor coming towards the floor. Keeping the tummy lifted, slowly drop the knee down to the floor. Now, keeping your, we're not going to keep our bum active. We're actually going to pulse our bum. So the back bum muscle that I always say keeps working, today we're going to start relaxed, and then you're going to squeeze it to push your hips a little bit deeper, and then relax. Squeeze it to push it a little bit deeper, and relax. So this is a bit of a ballistic kind of stretch. So you're squeezing and pushing the hips closer to the floor and then relaxing. Squeezing and pushing the hips closer to the floor, relaxing. Squeeze, relax. Squeeze, relax. It's nice stretching out this hip flexor, especially after those little leg exercises. And then we're going to lean back and and lift your foot into a flexed position as you're trying to drop your bum towards your back foot. Keep the belly lifted, tuck your hips under, and try and get into a nice stretch without dropping your bum onto your back foot and twisting in the hips. You want to keep squared. Think about your sternum pulling towards your shin. Then try and flatten your front foot onto the floor. And then lift into a flex. And flatten. And flex. Notice how it changes the stretch just slightly. Come back forward, stretching into the hip flex again. Now just squeeze your bum and push your hips down. Everyone, stay in that position. I'm just turning around on my mat. Okay, now we're going to start coming back up again, but we're twisting around to face forward. So our right leg is now bent and the foot is behind us, and the left leg straightens out to the side, like so. Make sure these hips are tucked under, belly is lifted. And we're going to place our right hand up towards the sky and pulling it over towards the straightened leg. So you're feeling a nice stretch pulling up the side of the body here. And then we place the right hand on the floor. If it's too intense for you to place your hand flat, you can go up onto your tippy fingers, see what works well for you. Our left hand then scoops the energy, pulls it up, and pulls long, 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 long. Remember, there's like a ball under us, so we're lifting up over the ball and stretching. Then I want you to start turning your chest towards the floor just slightly and feel how the stretch changes and starts going towards the QLs. Keep lifting, so you're lifting up over a ball. And slowly back to the side. And then from here, we're imagining a bit of a pulsating. So we've just stretched our arm long, and then we're bending, opening the chest. Feel how it changes the stretch up the side of the body. Then straighten, and then open up the chest, bending that arm backwards. Straighten, and open up the chest, bending that arm. Straighten, and open up the chest. And slowly we come back up to our straightened position. How's everyone doing? Remember to keep breathing, keep going. Hands are now both coming up towards the ceiling, lifting long, and then we're leaning forward, trying to come onto our elbows, and then we're going to let the straight leg slip away. So we're opening up into a bit of an inner thigh side stretch. Keep the tummy lifted, keep your hips tucking under. Gently push back up. Now we're in a nice outstretched position. Let's bring this bent leg around into our pigeon position. Just readjust yourself as you need to and send your back leg backwards, getting a deeper bum stretch. Lift in the belly and come onto your elbows and stretch out your bum. Feel like you're pushing down in that front leg and release. Push down on the front leg and release. Push down on the front leg, release. Push down on the front leg and release. One more. Push down on the front leg and release. Come back up onto your hands, tuck your back toe, lift. And now we're going backwards to do everything on the other leg. So bring your left leg up towards your left elbow. Bring it into your pigeon position. Walk your right leg back onto your elbows. Make sure you're squeezing the straight leg's bum to push the hips down and keeping your belly lifted. Push down on that front leg and release. Push down on the front leg and release. Push down on the front leg and release. Push down and release. One more. Push down on the front leg and release. Okay, we're going to come up. You guys wait 2 seconds because I need to turn around, otherwise you're just going to be watching my butt do everything. Okay, so now we're coming back up. This knee that is bent in front of us is twisting back behind us like we were, but obviously now we're on the other leg. The right leg is stretching out further away from us as we lean forward into that opened leg stretchy position, getting the inner thighs. Back up onto your hands, pull that leg back into position so that your knee and hip are stacked on top of each other. Lift the belly, tuck the hips under, arms are being pulled straight. Then we're going to go over to the front or the straightened leg, leaning forward. Pull the top hand away, feel that stretch coming up the side of the body. Back up to straightened. I need to derobe quick. And then we go over to the left side. So our hand is placed on the floor. We're lifting up over a ball and then the right hand stretches long. Make sure you're pushing your hips forward. Then we're going to start turning our chest towards the floor, very slowly, letting that arm pull longer. and slowly up again. And up we come. Now I need to remember my orientation. Then we're turning towards the right leg. You bring it in again so that we're sort of at that 90 degree angle so that we can get into that leaning front, left hip flexor down towards the floor stretch. That's a low lunge. This back bum cheek, we're going to start off pulsing it. So you're pulse squeezing it, pushing it deeper in towards the floor, and then release. Push towards the floor and release. Push towards the floor, hold it, release. Push towards the floor. You can feel as you activate that bum muscle that you're getting a deeper stretch in the hip flexor. Release, push towards the floor. And release, push towards the floor. Release, push towards the floor. And then let's start leaning back, straightening the right leg. First, we flex the foot. Suck the belly, tuck the hips under. Think about your sternum coming towards your shin. Flatten your front foot. And flex. Flatten. Notice the difference in the stretch. And flex. Flatten and flex. Remember to breathe. Flatten and start leaning forward again. Now we're just squeezing the left bum cheek to push the hips down. Tuck your back toe, lift up into that lunge position, bounce your foot slightly forward, and then we're going to start opening up towards the side, going into a forward fold with legs open. First, we're starting off with straight legs. Tuck the belly under, suck the hips under, suck the hips under. Tuck the hips under, suck the belly up towards the spine. Then think about your sternum pulling towards the floor. So we're not dropping our head just yet. We're just feeling a lengthening happening down the spine and a stretch that's pulling up the calf muscles as well as the hammies. And start pulsing backwards and forwards, or rather up and down, keeping that sternum like it's trying to pull towards the ground. This is going into a bit of a ballistic stretch again. Now you can drop your head and just hang. Grab your ankles on the inside of your legs and pull. Oh, I'm starting to jiggle. That's a great sign. Remember, guys, the legs shaking, you're just releasing trauma. Let it fly. Your knees and allow yourself to hang. Now my hands have moved to the outside of my legs, but it's just because they're resting there. I'm not actually actively pulling my body at all. Keep sucking your belly up. Bend a little bit deeper and straighten.
bend a little bit deeper and straighten. Bend, straighten, bend, straighten. Bend and lift your body up. Turn your blank right leg to face the wall or the straight. And then the back foot is staying at this 45 degree angle as we come into our warrior two position. We're not going into a deep warrior two. We're focusing on lifting the hips and tucking the hips under. Our chest is facing forward and our arms are straight out. This is something we're going to play with a bit. So we're going from the warrior two. You're going to bounce the knee, bounce the knee, bounce the knee, and then bounce into warrior one. Keep the belly lifted, keep the hips tucked under. This is where your balance stays. So if you let go, you're going to flop. If you keep tucked under, you should be okay. Bounce, 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 warrior two. We're going to straighten the front leg and go into our triangle pose. Remember, we're lifting up over a ball, so we're not collapsing here. We're lifting, pushing the hips forward, tucking our hips under. You go as far as you can. If you can only get up to your shin, hold your shin and chill there. Otherwise, you just keep dropping down, pushing the hips forward. Come back up into your warrior two. We're going to drop our right elbow onto our right knee and lengthen the left arm away from us, over our head. Pull, pull, pull. Then bring it back over, keeping your front leg bent. Grab your back leg, lifting your right arm up and over. Reverse triangle. Reverse warrior. Come back up. And now we're tucking the right foot forward again, interlacing our fingers behind our backs, making sure these hips are tucked under, bellies lifted. And now if you can keep your palms together, you keep them together, you'll see now as I come up, we're lifting our arms up and over and letting them hang. So if it's easier for you to just interlace the fingers, that's where you stay. For a deeper stretch, hold the palms together. And just hang, keep your belly lifted. Bend the knees and try and let your arms drop a little bit further towards the floor. Remember, these shoulders shouldn't be dropping towards your ears. They're lifted away from your ears. Up we come, releasing the hands, and now we're doing that whole sequence on the other side. So we're turning our left foot forward, coming into our warrior two position. If you need to readjust space, go for it. Tuck the hips under, suck the belly up, arms out to the side, our sternum is facing forward. Or sideways, that could be forward. Staying in line with our hips. And we're gonna go. Oh, I've forgotten what I actually did. Let's go into our triangle pose. So you straighten the front leg into triangle. Keep the belly lifted. Ah, I remember now. Remember to keep breathing. Keep these hips forward and let them drop backwards. Keep the tummy lifted. Back into your warrior position. Now we're going to bounce that front knee, bounce, bounce, bounce into warrior one. Oh, there we go. I slipped. Keep the tummy lifted and pulling up in the body. bounce, 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 back into your warrior two position. Now we're going to take the left elbow onto the left knee, leaning that right arm forward, feel it pulling, 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 tucking the hips under, lifting in the belly. And then we come and reverse warrior. Keep the hips pushing forward. And up we come again. Twist into warrior one, up into standing. And you guys nailed that. Well done. Okay, so now we're coming back onto the floor. Whew. After you've been worked and warmed up a plenty, I hope, we're going to get into deeper hip capsule stretching. So we just did the ones where we drop the knees in, and then we did ones where we side to side. Now we're doing a similar idea. Actually, let me face forward. But it's just one leg that drops down at a time, which can make it much deeper. It'll also be nice to stretch these guys again after the leg lifting doodads. Okay, so you open your legs again. You're trying to get your ankles and your knees in a line. You can lean back a bit if you want to. And instead of dropping both knees in at the same time, we're dropping just one. And just hold it at the point where it's still a pleasant stretch. It's not like you're like, oh, I'm dying. It's like, oh, okay, I can feel it, cool. Lift that knee gently. And then just do the other leg, leaning it in. Lift that back up. Whew. Straighten your legs out in front of you, and let's do a nice forward fold to just stretch out these legs a little bit more. Flexing the feet, arms are lifting up long, hips are tucked under, legs are pushing down into the ground, and we lift over our Pilates ball and grab our feet. If you can grab your ankle or your shins, whatever works for you, and just feel the stretch pulling up the hammies. Sucking the belly, you want to think about your sternum pulling towards your ankles. It's all clear, perfectly crystal. I've been here long enough to know when to leave and when to tell you. And gently release. The next one we're going to do is using our imagination. So you're going to lie on your back nicely. When I say nicely, the unnice is having an arch in the back over here and your shoulders up here somewhere, so you're sort of uncomfortable. So a nice lying on the back is tucking the hips under. I push my head down into the floor to lift my shoulders, rotate them into their sockets, and then put them on the floor. And now I can feel my whole spine from about behind my, where my clavicle is, all the way down, 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 down to my coccyx is nicely laid out on the floor. So this is a nice sleep on your back. We've got our feet coming up towards our bum. And what we're going to do is we're going to imagine we've got a ball in between our legs. So it's sort of just here where your knees are. So first we're going to tuck our hips, sucking our belly down even more. And then we're going to imagine we're trying to squeeze this ball. So our knees aren't going to come together, but they're pulling in towards each other like they're against a ball. So you should feel your inner thighs saying, hello, good morning, I'm here today. And release. Now we're going to pretend that there's one of those loop bands around our legs, and now we want to open our legs. They're not going to move because we're imagining that band's there, but we're imagining us trying to open our legs. So then we're getting into our little saddlebag muscles. Keep the belly tucked down towards the floor. And release. Now we're going back to the ball, trying to squeeze the legs closed. Tuck the hips, squeeze. Relax. And now we're going to open. Tuck the hips under, trying to open the legs. Release. Squeeze the ball. Release, try and open the legs. And release. Take a moment, breathe in, out. And our next one is going to come deep into our core muscles. So now we're not wanting to lift the bum off the floor, but we are tucking, and we should feel probably our coccyx just gently lifting, but we're not aiming to actually pick the bum up off the floor. So we're pushing our feet into the ground, literally pushing, and then tucking the hips under, feeling the bum activating. So literally the coccyx lift, and that's where you hold it. So you're pushing into the ground. There should be some activation here. And then release and push and release, push, release, push, release, push. Hold it. I'm just going to hold for a bit. Important to keep sucking the belly down towards the floor and release. Alright, our next set of exercises is targeting our core muscles again and a little bit into the transverse section. So these are our side muscles, side abdomen muscles. So if you suffer with your neck, you can leave your head on the floor if you don't mind too much. Then you can keep your head lifted. We're tucking our hips under. We're lifting our body. One leg comes up. So let's start with left leg, right hand. Pushes against the leg, but the leg pushes back as well. So you're creating tension. And you should feel these tummy muscles activating. Release. Swap over. And push your hand into your leg. Your leg pushes back into your hand. Keep sucking belly down and release. Oh, my neck gets tired. So keep going and tuck, pushing knee into hand, hand into knee, getting into the tummy muscles. Release, other side. Release. First side, left knee, right hand. Make sure, feel your own belly muscles. Are you activating nicely? You should feel your lower abdomen as well as your upper abdomen working. Release. Right leg, left hand. And release. Pull your knees up into your armpit area so the legs are open. Suck your belly down and just feel your lower back opening. Good. have your feet going into your happy baby pose. So your elbows are, your knees are pulling down past your armpits if you're able. Keep sucking your belly back towards the floor. Now start pushing your feet into your hands. So you're pushing up, but your hands are trying to pull back, so there's a little bit of tension happening. Resistance, it's resistance, not tension. And release. Roll up onto your bum. And we're going to work on our Bhargavasana. Bring your feet together. Don't bring them so close to your Forksy bonnet, or as close as you can bring them to your Forksy bonnet. Leave a little bit of extra space. Interlace your fingers around your toes. And then we're pushing out the soles of our feet together gently so that we can activate our bum muscles to bring our knees closer to the floor and open our hips up more. Then we're thinking about the sternum being pulled towards the toes. So we're lengthening up the spine and then coming towards our feet. Remember to keep breathing and try and pull your sternum closer towards your feet, deepening your stretch. Bounce backwards and forwards. This is lovely for the inner thighs as well as the lower back, as well as the shoulders, if you can allow it to just let the shoulders relax as well. Make sure your shoulders aren't crawling up towards your ears, but dropping down. Well done, everyone. If you want to get your warm things back on, and we'll get ready for relaxation. Let's start off with a nice deep breath in. Exhale through the mouth, feeling your whole body just release tension. Deep breath in. Out through the mouth, releasing more tension. Last one, deep breath in. And out through the mouth. Feel your body growing more and more relaxed and heavy, comfortable and cozy as you breathe in and out, steadily paying attention to your breath, paying attention to the movement of your body as you breathe, and the feeling of the air as it enters and exits your body. Following the idea of the Vayus at the beginning of class, I want you to imagine throughout your entire body there are little worker creatures. You can create whatever you want. If you watched Osmosis Jones, then you've got an idea of cool animated little dudes working in your body to keep your body healthy and functioning. Maybe you just see little mini human beings working in your body, keeping your cells in action and happy and getting rid of toxins and sending things off into the bloodstream. Your imagination, go wild here. And I want you to imagine any areas in your body that might feel sore, maybe a bit disconnected from, I'm going to call, have a lower feeling frequency in your body. So notice these areas, and I want you to imagine that as you're breathing in, these areas are starting to come alive because you're bringing in that Vayu energy into these areas to help them function even better. So as you breathe in, it brings this oxygenation to them, and it wakes the employees up, so to speak. So whatever your characters are, maybe they were falling asleep because they hadn't had enough oxygen for the day, and that's why it's feeling a little bit knee, that niggly feeling. And now you're bringing this oxygen, and they're like, I'm feeling energized. Let's get to work, fellas. And they start repairing and healing and sending toxins out and keeping this area all lush and gorgeous and life-filled. And you start doing this for all the areas. So allow yourself the space to do each section, each area that you feel is a bit darker or not quite functioning or maybe a little bit sore and achy. And you just keep on bringing that Vayu energy through the nose, comes into your chest, and from the chest it starts spreading out to all the areas that you need it to go into. And pay each one attention, noticing how the employees are waking up, how they're starting to function and get the whole area cleaned up and happy. Then go to the next one and start seeing everyone waking up, starting to function, and so on and so forth. Just keep paying attention to the breath and how it brings more and more invigorating energy to each part of your body. Remember to keep bringing in that Vayu energy to each sector of your body. If you get distracted by thoughts, it's okay. Just remind yourself to keep coming back, bringing in that prana energy through your breath. Thank you. start imagining that as you bring in this prana energy through your nose, through your air, your entire body, everyone working in your body, almost starts a Mexican flag of celebration as each round of energy invigorates them and lets them carry on merrily doing what they need to do to keep your body healthy and happy and feeling good and light and fun-filled. Every inhalation, Mexican wave of woohoo! Feel as your entire body celebrates, feeling joyous and grateful for every breath you take. And it's that simple. Just breathing allows your body to feel joyous. Take a moment to feel grateful for everyone looking after your body. Each sector that is making sure that waste disposal is done and nutrient distribution is taken care of, oxygenation is happening throughout the body. Just feel the gratitude move through you. And then take a nice deeper than you were breath in. Exhaling through the mouth, creating more relaxation. Another deep breath in. And as you exhale, we start wiggling our fingers, wiggling our toes, bringing our awareness back into where we are right now. Give your body one last stretch. And then you can come up to seated and join me for one om. Have your hands on your knees or into your heart center. Take a deep breath in. Thank you, everybody.